Let's discuss an example. Here, we are required to find the minimum value of s, which is given as ax plus by if xy is equals to r square. Now, here you can see the value which is to be minimized is s, which is given in terms of two variables x and y. So, to maximize or minimize, first we need to express it in terms of a single variable, and that we'll do by this, like s can be written as ax plus b. The value of y we can substitute it from here, which will be r square by x. Now, s is given in terms of x. Here we can say, here s is minimum when ds over dx is equals to 0. If you just differentiate it, this will give you ds by dx is equals to a minus br square by x square is equals to 0. On solving, you will get the value of x. Here the value of x can be written as root of b by a into r. So this is the value of x for which the derivative of s with respect to x becomes 0. Now just to check whether it is at this value of x, this is s is becoming maximum or minimum, we just find out the second derivative. So it is d square s by dx square. Your differentiation of a will be 0 and 1 by x square will be differentiated as minus 2 by x cube. So this will become plus 2br square by x cube. If we put the value of x, obviously the result is coming out to be positive. This implies s is minimum at this particular value. If we wish to find out the minimum value of s, minimum value of s can be given as, it will be given by this expression by substituting the value of x over here. So here it is a into x, we can write as root of b by a into r plus it is b r square divided by root of b by a into r. If this one r gets cancelled out, the result will be root of ab into r plus again root of ab into r. This will be twice of root ab into r. This will be the answer to the question. Dear students, let's discuss another example. It says a cardboard of size 12 cm by 12 cm cut at 4 of its corners such that equal squares of size y by y cm are cut at each corner. Now the sides are folded to make an open box. We are required to find the value of y so that the volume of this box is a maximum. Now, if we just have a look, say if this is a cardboard which is given of size 12 cm by 12 cm. It is saying we are going to cut 4 corners and at each corner we are cutting the square of side y cm by y cm. So these are the corners which are cut, and after cutting these squares, if we fold these sides, it will become an open box like this. Here you can see the square cut is of dimension y. So if this is also y, the middle dimension which is left over after cutting both the corners is 12 minus 2y. Here it will become like an open box of this shape. You just have a look very carefully on this. This will be a box like this, and it will be of height y, and the sides will be of side 12 minus 2y and 12 minus 2y. Now we are required to find the value of y so that the volume of this box will be maximum. Here if we calculate the volume of this box, this volume can be given as base area multiplied by height. It will be 12 minus 2y whole square into y. Now here v will be maximum when dv over dy is equals to 0. If we just differentiate this expression, it will be done by product rule, 12 minus 2y whole square into y. So here dv over dy can be given as, we'll keep 12 minus 2y whole square as it is. We just differentiate this y, which is 1, plus we keep y as it is. It is twice of 12 minus 2y into minus 2. This will equate it to 0. On solving this expression, we'll get 12 minus 2y minus 4y is equals to 0. This implies 6y is equals to 12. Hence, y is equals to 2 cm. This is the answer to our question that at y equals to 2 cm, the volume of this box will be maximum. And whether it is maximum or minimum, that you can check by second derivative check, that you can handle at your own level, or you just verify it by second derivative check that at y equals to 2 cm, d square y by dy square is coming out to be a negative quantity. Let's take up another example. Here we are required to find the maximum area of an isosceles triangle which can be inscribed in a circle of radius 6 cm. Let's take up an attempt. Say we are having a circle and it is of radius 6 cm. If we try to frame an isosceles triangle in it, so if this is an isosceles triangle, here say the length of base, we consider it to be 2L, say if this is L, this is radius, and from center of circle to the base, say if this distance is X. In this situation, the area of this triangle can be given as, this will be half into L into 2 into x plus 6. So this will be L into x plus 6 will be the area of this triangle. We need to maximize this area. So we need to express this area in terms of a single variable. Here it depends on value of L as well as value of x. So we can relate L and x to eliminate one of these variables. So here we can write L square plus x square is equals to 6 square, that is 36. So here we can write the value of L to be root of 36 minus x square. If we substitute it here, the value of area of this isosceles triangle can be written as root of 36 minus x square into x plus 6. Now we are having area in terms of a single variable x, that is the height of center above the base of this triangle. Here we can say A will be maximum when dA over dx is equals to 0. So here if we calculate the value of dA by dx, this can be written as, here we will differentiate it by using product rule. Here we keep x plus 6 a constant, and root of 36 minus x square, if we differentiate, it will be 1 by twice of root of 36 minus x square into minus 2x. This 2 can also be cancelled out. Plus, we keep root of 36 minus x square as it is, and differentiation of x plus 6 is 1. So this is equated to 0. Now if we simplify the relation, let's see what we are getting. Here we'll be getting x plus 6 x. So it will be what? This will give us minus of x square minus 6 x plus 36 minus x square is equals to 0. So this will give us 2 x square plus 6 x minus 36 is 0, or x square plus 3x minus 18 is equals to 0. We can directly factorize it. It can be written as x plus 6 into x minus 3 is equals to 0. This implies we are getting two values of x, that is minus 6 and 3. Obviously, this negative value we can discard. we need to take up only one value of x, that is equals to 3. So at x equals to 3 we can say, because here you can see the value of x can never go to negative values, because for negative values the area is certainly going to decrease. So at x equals to 3 we can say that dA by dx is 0. So at x equals to 3 we can simply calculate the value of area, and it will be maximum. That you can verify by using self-derivative check at your own end. You just differentiate the expression once again and put the value of x equals to 3. Certainly you are going to get a negative value, which shows that area is maximum at x equals to 3. So here maximum value of A is, this can be given as, if we put the value of x equals to 3, this will give us root of 36 minus 9. This will be root of 36 minus 9, and this will be 3 plus 6. See what you'll be getting. This will be 9 root 27, or it can be written as 27 root 3 square centimeter, which is the answer to this question. That is the maximum area of an isosceles triangle which can be inscribed in a circle of radius 6 inches.